गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 5, वेलकम टू आवर ई लर्निंग क्लास. दिस इज अ रेनी मॉर्निंग. आर यू एंजॉयिंग दिस? ओके, टुडे वी विल बी प्रोसीडिंग विथ इंग्लिश ग्रामर. टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 9, एडजेक्टिव्स. इन द लास्ट क्लास वी डिड चैप्टर नंबर 8, नाउंस पोजेशन. एंड फ्रॉम दैट चैप्टर ओनली वन थिंग इज लेफ्ट, क्वेश्चन नंबर जी. Okay, so question number G, you can leave this question number G. Okay, today we are not doing, so please don't do number G. If it is necessary, we will do it later. Now we will shift to chapter number 9, adjectives. So what are adjectives? Adjectives are describing words. Adjectives tell us what kind of, how many, what type of persons, animals or things are. Okay, in short, as we know, naming words are nouns. Similarly, describing words are adjectives. For example, he is a good boy. Here the word good tells us what type of a boy he is. A good boy. So good, this word, it is an adjective because it describes what type of boy he is. That's why it is an adjective. The room is empty. How is that room? That room is empty. Empty is here describing word, so it is an adjective. Different types of adjectives are here. Today, at first, we will describe adjectives of quality. The first one is adjectives of quality. What is an adjective of quality? An adjective of quality tells us what kind of a person or thing is. What kind of a person or thing is called an adjective of quality. For example, I met an old man. That means I met a man who is old. Here old tells us what type of that man is. Old here describes what type of man he is. He is an old man. So old is adjective of quality. Obviously it is an adjective, but it is adjective of quality. So another is, he is hungry. He is hungry. So hungry also tells us how he is, what type of he is feeling now. Okay, he is hungry. Here hungry is the describing word. Okay, so it is also adjective of quality. So now come to the page number 30, chapter 9, page number 30. Page number 30, come to the question number D. Underline the adjective of quality in the following sentences. We have to underline adjectives of quality. Number 1, I met an old man with grey hair. Here, old and grey, they are adjectives of quality. Grey tells us what type of hair? Grey color. So, grey, adjective of quality. And old man, old, it tells us, so it is also adjective of quality. Number 2, Shivaji was a brave and fearless ruler. Here brave and fearless, both are adjectives of quality. So please underline these two words. Number 3, big tears rolled down her beautiful cheeks. Big and beautiful, these two words are adjectives of quality, so please underline. Number 4, only noble people can form great nations. Only noble people can form great nations. So noble and great, these are adjectives of quality, please underline. Number 5, a fierce fight took place between the mighty warrior. What type of warrior? Mighty. And what type of fight? Fierce fight. So underline fierce and mighty. Number 6. The hungry lion could not catch the clever fox. What type of fox? Clever. And hungry lion. So, hungry and clever. Underline. Number 7. The ancient palace was converted into a grand museum. What type of palace? Ancient palace. What type of museum? Grand museum. So, underline ancient and grand. Number 8. It was a warm sunny day and a light breeze was blowing. How was the day? What type of a day it was? It was warm and sunny. Okay. So, please underline warm and sunny. And what type of breeze? Light breeze. So, underline light. Clear? Number E. Fill in the blanks with adjectives of quality. Take these adjectives from those given below. So, some words are given, some adjectives are given in the box. So, just find out the right adjective and fill in the blanks. Number 1. These medicines are bitter. B-I-T-T-E-R. Bitter. Number 2. Noble deeds. Noble. N-O-B-L-E. Noble deeds bring satisfaction to the heart. Number 3. A chilly wind. Chilly. Number 4. The rest of the road was flat and smooth. The rest of the road was flat and smooth. Number 5. Her house is in a shabby part of the town. Right? Shabby. S-H-A-B-B-Y. Number 6. We should eat healthy food. Healthy. Number 7. The handsome prince came riding a horse. Handsome. So, come to page number 31. We discussed adjective of quality. Now, we will discuss adjectives of quantity. Quantity means amount. Okay? An adjective which tells how much of a thing is meant. How much of a thing is meant is called an adjective of quantity. Okay? So, for example, I need some food. Here the word some, it tells us how much food I need, how much. Okay, so it is adjective of quantity. For example, some, enough, much, many, much. These are adjectives of quantity. Another is adjectives of number. An adjective which tells us how many persons or things are meant. Adjectives of quantity, adjective of quantity tells us how much of a thing. And adjective of number tells us how many persons, how many things are meant. Okay, so these are the difference between adjective of quantity and adjective of number. If I say I need many books, here many is adjective of number. But if I say I need much food, okay, then it is adjective of quantity. Clear? Now another is adjectives like first, third, tenth, which are derived from numbers, are also called adjective of number. Okay, such adjectives show in what order a person or thing stands. Therefore, they are also called ordinal adjectives. They are also called ordinal adjectives. The first, second, third, these are. Now, come to, as I told, give me some milk. Some, it denotes quantity. So, it is adjectives of quantity. And all the members are present today. All here means all. How many? It answers how many. So this is adjectives of number. Okay, it is not adjective of quantity, it is adjective of number. Now come to page number 32. Page number 32, question number J. Here write Q for adjectives of quantity and N for adjective of number. Okay, the first one, a week has 7 days. 7 is a number, isn't it? So it is adjective of number. So write capital N in the box. Number two, many roads were damaged in the rains. Many roads are damaged in the rains. So it is many quantity, right? Q. Number three, my father gave me some advice before the school trip. Some, it is quantity, right? Q. Number four, he gave the ball to the first student. First, it is N, adjective of number. Number five, are there enough people to complete the work in time? Here we can write it adjective of number, N. Okay. Number six, there is enough rice in the bag. Here it is adjective of quantity, because you cannot count rice, but you can count people. That's why in question number five, enough people, that is adjective of number, right? N. But in number six, there is enough rice, it is adjective of quantity, right? Q. Number seven, we have no complaints against these workers. No complaint. So number, there was no milk for the baby. Quantity, because milk, you cannot count how many milks are there, isn't it? Milk is uncountable. That's why it is adjective of quantity, right? Q. But number seven, you can count how many complaints are there. So that's why it is adjective of number, right? N. Now, next thing is demonstrative adjectives. Next thing is demonstrative adjective. An adjective which is used to point out some person or thing. An adjective that is used to point out some person or thing is called a demonstrative adjective. That means an adjective that demonstrate some person or thing. And a demonstrative adjective answers the question, which one? A demonstrative adjective answers the question, which one? So that is demonstrative adjective. Okay, for example, this pen writes well. Which one? This pen. So this, it is demonstrative adjectives. Okay, now such people do not fail in life. Which people? Such people. So such, it is demonstrative adjective. Clear? Now those boys are very naughty. Which one? Those boys. These boys are very intelligent. These, those, that, these, such, all are demonstrative adjective. Clear? Now THI is this. It is used for singular number, to denote singular number. And THESE, it is used for plural number. You all know that, those, this, these, you know, singular number and plural number. Now come to question number M. Underline the demonstrative adjectives in the following sentences. Okay, number one, this box is heavy. This, THI is this, underline. Number two, these trousers. So which one is demonstrative adjective? These, THES, these. Number three, that house belongs to Mala. So demonstrative adjective is that. Underline. Number four, those shops were built last year. Underline. Yes, those. Number 6. Such men become popular. Underline such. Number 6. I have read these books. So these underline. Number 7. Kavita has joined that school. Underline that. We are selling this car. Underline this. Who brought those flowers? Who brought those flowers? Those underline. Number 10. Everybody loves such children. Underline such. Number 9. Make the following phrases plural. Now we will make these following phrases plural. Number 1 is already given. The answer is given. So we will move to question number 2. This cute white puppy. So we will make it plural. We will write these. These. Plural of this. It is these. These cute white and it is not puppy. It will be puppies. P-U-P-P-I-S. Because these plural number. These cute white puppies. Now come to question number 3. This new red car. Right. These new red cars. Plural number. Number 4. That big oak tree. So write those. Plural of that. It is those. Those big oak trees. Now number 5. That fresh pink rose. So you will write those fresh pink roses. Roses. Number 6. Such a lovely baby. So please write such lovely babies. Not such a. Please do not write a. Such lovely babies. B-A-B-I-E-S. Number 7. This colorful silken feather. So the plural number is these. T-H-E-S-E. These colorful silken feathers. Clear? So students, today we will do question number O. We will do up to question number O. Make the following phrases singular. The first one is given already. So number 2. These brave soldiers. You will write this. T-H-I-S. This brave soldier. Number 3. This honest and polite man. T-H-I-S. This honest and polite man. M-A-N. I am telling the answer only. Okay. Number 4. Those rare diamond rings. So please write that rare diamond ring. R-I-N-G. Number 5. Those funny stories. You will write that. T-H-A-T. That funny story. S-T-O-R-Y. Then number 6. Such sharp knives. You will write such a sharp knife. K-N-I-F-E. Such a sharp knife. K-N-I-F-E. Number 7. Those interesting books. So write that. T-H-A-T. That interesting book. B-O-O-K. Students, we will complete this chapter in the next class. Okay. So please practice again and again. Whatever we discussed today, do it again and again. Hope it will be easy for you. Thank you so much.